first of all, there's a lot of misunderstanding when it comes to what reduction is. In Southwestern pottery, a lot of what we call reduction, like Maria Martinez black on black pottery, for example, is not actually reduced. It's smudged, it's smothered. That's carbon you're seeing, it's not reduced iron. And a lot of people think it's reduction, but it's not. And the reason we know that it's not is, have you ever seen some of those potters in San Ildefonso or Santa Clara, some of those places where they make the black on black pottery, they will use aluminum foil in areas like on the rim or in little cutouts, and they'll place it over the pottery before they fire it. And then when they pull it out, the areas that are covered in foil will be brown or reddish brown, and then the other areas will be black. If it was actually reduced iron, it would reduce everywhere because they were keeping oxygen out of everything, right? But it's actually it's carbon. It's smudging, not reduced. And the same way, there's another thing they do. They'll take a blowtorch, a little propane torch, and they will burn off that black in designs after the firing. Now, if it was reduced iron, you would not be burning the black away. It's carbon. That's what they're doing, is burning it away. So most Southwest pottery is not reduced at all. Prehistorically, members pottery was all reduced. A lot of that Cibola whiteware, like Tularosa and stuff, a lot of that was reduced as well, because that paint is actually iron. You'll see areas where it turns red. You can refire it in electric kiln today, and those black designs will turn red. How they do that, nobody, literally, that I'm aware of, nobody knows how they were reducing pottery back in prehistoric times. But when you start a fire, when you do an outside firing, it is reducing at first. In the first, you know, let's say you fire over the course of an hour, just for simplicity. Most of my firings are less than an hour, but let's say it lasts an hour. That first half hour is going to be reducing, and then it's going to slowly gradiate towards oxidation towards the end. So when it first starts lighting, there's all that smoke and fumes coming up. That fire is actively combusting, lots of flames. There's very little oxygen inside there for that pottery. And at that time, you have a reduction atmosphere. And then as that fire starts burning to coals, there's less flames, there's less smoke. It starts slowly gradiating toward oxidation. And so at the end, when you have all those coals just sitting on top of that pot, you're in a good oxidizing atmosphere. And so almost all outdoor firings have a combination of reduction and oxidation. If you wanted to keep it, and this is all hypothetical, if you wanted to keep it reduced, let's say I was a members potter, or I was trying to make members pottery, I would want to smother it at that point before it started oxidizing, or at least before the iron started oxidizing. Now, when you're making, let's say, Mesa Verde black on white organic paint pottery, it's the same way. They let it oxidize to the point that if you pull those pots out, if you smother it too early, they'll come out all black. They'll all be covered with carbon, right? The pots. But they let it oxidize to the point that it's burned all the carbon off of the pot before they smother it. So there is some oxidation. That's why Clint Swink doesn't call it reduction. He calls it limited oxidation, because you're oxidizing enough to clean the surface up to make it look nice and bright, and then you're smothering it, keeping the oxygen out. So it's kind of a fuzzy gray area.